tea remedy if you are feeling low. Have a cold, especially for South Indians. It is nothing but pepper rasam. It is a very simple to make recipe which can be made very fast with few ingredients in the right quantity, and it tastes very heavenly, yummy with papad or your potato fry, or if you are a non-vegetarian, any of your non-vegetarian dry dishes. So let us go and see how to make this simple and easy pepper rasam. To prepare pepper rasam, ingredients required are 1 gooseberry size tamarind, around 10 to 15 pods of garlic, 1 tablespoon of cumin seeds, 1 tablespoon of pepper seeds, 4 to 5 red chilies, mustard seeds, 1 teaspoon, 1 tomato, few coriander leaves and few curry leaves. So let's get started with the process. First, let us take the tamarind and soak it in water. Let it soak completely. In the meanwhile, let us prepare the other ingredients. Let's take a mortar and pestle, add in pepper and cumin seeds and pound it well. I'm getting the nice aroma of pepper and cumin being pounded. So this is done. I've made a coarse powder. You can see this. Not completely powdered, but coarse. This I'm going to drop in here. Next, in the same mortar and pestle, I'm taking the garlic and pounding it. So all the garlic is pounded. I'm going to add this also into this. Add in salt to taste. Break the red chilies and add it in. I am also breaking the corianders and adding it in. Along with the stem, I am just adding it in. Tomato, I am taking it with my hand, giving it a squeeze so that all the juice gets released. Always take a ripe tomato. Then putting that also in. You can also cut it and keep, but if you cut, you'll lose the juice. Drop it in and then start squeezing everything together, or rather mash it with your hands. So I'm able to get the smell now, the aroma of pepper, cumin and the coriander leaves and the curry leaves have started to infuse. I'm also getting the garlic smell. So this is the pepper rasam. You can skip the tomato if you don't like. I'm adding a tomato because I like the taste of tomato a lot. I'll also give you a list of ingredients which can be skipped if you don't have it readily available. You cannot skip pepper, you cannot skip jeera, you cannot skip tamarind, you cannot skip salt, and you cannot skip garlic. Other than that, if you don't have curry leaves, if you don't have coriander leaves, that's fine. And if you don't have red chili, you can use green chili in its place, but use some chili. Don't use chili powder. Even one chili is fine. Number of chilies depends on taste. If you like it spicy, increase the number of chilies, or increase the quantity of pepper by another half a spoon. See how I am making a pulp? You see the pulp? All the ingredients are squished and the juice is getting infused into the water. You can also opt to take off the pulp of the tamarind. I am anyways going to discard all this, so I thought pulp also doesn't impact. There is a reason I haven't taken off the pulp of the tamarind beforehand. This is the village style pepper rasam. So I have mashed it completely. Next, we need to do the tempering. I'm taking a pan. You can take a vessel as well. Switch on the stove. Let the pan get hot. Add some oil. Add in the mustard seeds. Let it splutter. Add in one red chili. Curry leaves. And transfer this rasam. Rasam usually is very watery. So add in water. Remember, rasam should never come to a boil, can only froth. So once it starts frothing, you have to switch off the stove. See the sides of the pan where a small boil is getting started. So that is where the frothing will start. So the rasam has started to froth. You can see a layer on top. So this is when you switch off the stove. So tasty pepper rasam is ready. Thank you for watching. If you liked the video, please like, share and subscribe, and let me know how else you prepare rasam at your household and how it has turned out for you.